Hello, and welcome to a new EasyDigitals.com video tutorial. Remember, you can get all of our high-quality Photoshop and Photoshop Elements templates at EasyDigitals.com. Just click on the Products button. And don't forget to sign up for our monthly newsletter. We give away free templates and tutorials each and every month, along with product update info and coupons. Okay, Kim, what easy tutorial are you going to show us today?
Today I want to show you how to resize a 8x10 template. Many of our templates come in 8x10, and sometimes it's nice to be able to change it to a 5x7 or a 4x6. Some of our magazine covers make nice invitations for parties. The one we're going to be working with today is the cheerleading template. You can purchase that template at easydigitals.com, and it is magazine covers volume 2. So you just go to the magazine covers volume 2. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started on our resizing. I have the template up, the cheerleading template. So the first thing we want to do is we're going to click on our Move tool, and we're going to make sure Auto Select Layers is on and Show Transform Controls. So now I have my history and my layers up. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come to Image, Image Size, and if I wanted this to be for internet, I would change this to 72. Most internet images are at 72, so it would look like it was an 8x10, 72. If I wanted it to be smaller for the internet, I would just change it to 8 or 7, and as long as I have constrained proportions checkmarked, it's going to resize it and keep the aspect ratio. But for right now, we're going to change this back to 300, and we do want this to be a 5x7, so we're going to keep the height at 7. The width for right now we're going to keep at 5.6. It's a little bit too wide, but we're going to work on that next. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK, and I'm going to get my zoom tool and just zoom this in a little bit. Okay, so now we know the height is 7 and the width is 5.6. So we need to get this down to 5. So we're going to come over here to width, and we're going to put in 5 IN, and for height we're going to put in 7 IN. And we're going to leave resolution blank so that it won't change that. I'm going to come up here to my corner, and I'm just going to drag down, and it's going to show the marching ants. And I'm not going to press enter, I'm just going to drag a guide out to that spot, then right click and press cancel. So now I have my guide, so I know that I want all this information to be scooched over here and made smaller so that it shows up. I'm going to go ahead and click on my move tool, make this window a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to come up to this corner and I'm going to drag over everything so that everything is highlighted. And I'm going to come to my zoom, I'm going to press Alt, and that changes the zoom to a minus. And then I'm coming back to my move tool so I can see everything here. And I grab this little corner and I press Shift to keep the aspect ratio. And I'm zooming it in so that all of the important layers will be inside this guide here. And then I'm going to press Enter. Now I'm going to zoom back in. Okay, now my crop is still set to 5x7, so now I come in and I press Enter. Now some of this information just needs to be scooched around so that it looks right. These layers on the bottom here just need to scoot down, so I'm going to again drag over them to highlight them all, and I'm just going to arrow them down. Now you can modify this and just scoot things around till they look right, but that's pretty much it. So now let's say that I wanted this for the internet. Before you press save or anything, the first thing you want to do is save it, copy. So I just click save as, and I'm going to change this to 5x7 so that I have it saved as a 5x7. Delete this and I press save, and it asks me if I want to maximize compatibility, and I'll say yes. And there it is, it's 5x7. And it works the exact same way for 4x6. You're going to take a little bit more off the edge, and you're going to put 4x6 in the boxes, but it's the same thing. Let's go ahead and change this just so you can see for internet. I'm going to change this to 72, and I'm going to press OK. Now it looks like it got really small, but if I come up here to view and I click print size, then you'll see that this is what it would look like on the internet. Then you can go ahead and drag your picture in, resize. We have other tutorials that show you how to do that. So I hope this helped you. If you need to change any of these templates, they make really awesome invitations for parties, so you can have a lot of fun with it. Thanks a lot.
Hey, that was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about this tutorial or any of our products, you can always reach us at easydigitals.com. Have a creative day.